out of my way.
You, who are you? Might you be? Please wait, King Odin! Someone, stop him!
King Odin, 'tis an honor to see you here in person. Please excuse my servants.
They don't bother me, King Onyx. After all, we are equals, are we not? I have come here today because I have heard that my daughter is here.
Yes. The wise men of Titania have brought me my treasure. She receives the utmost respect, and I have no intention of returning her.
No wise man would call himself wise. They are a mere trio of ruffians.
Those so-called ruffians have told me to beware your country.
Really? How amusing. So they plan to influence an entire nation with a single girl. 'Tis insanity. Or could it be that the Fire Kingdom's soldiers may actually invade my country? This will bring about the war and the prophecies.
You're quite shrewd, but Princess Gwendolyn is so pure, it's impossible to believe she's your daughter. She sets my heart ablaze. Your daughter should be with me to watch the world fall into ruin.
Immortal you may be, but to be so immature. 'Tis appalling for one who calls himself the Inferno King. I shall snuff you out.
It never crossed my mind that the Demon Lord would care about his daughter and set foot in this fated land. 'Tis comforting. The spell you cast on your child will cause her to be mine.
So you know of the spell. Then do as you wish. Who knows? Perhaps you will get your wish after all.
What do you mean?
So there was one thing I never picked up on. Welcome to the finale of Oswald's story, by the way. One thing I hadn't really picked up on until now, I don't know if it's expressly stated or if I have never properly paid attention to it, is the way Odin reacts there. And I don't think it's him thinking it's Oswald coming, and that's the reason he's, getting some jollies out of this whole thing. I think it's the whole spell that was put on her. Because one of the problems with the story is, like, is there really a love story between Gwendolyn and Oswald throughout part of this game, if it's a spell? And really, it's not. Because, you know, the spell doesn't actually cause her to fall in love, it's just a sleeping spell. So in the end, she only thinks she's under that spell, and then she ends up, you know, falling in love with Oswald anyway. Is that a spoiler for stuff at all? I don't think so, because I don't really remember that being stated as, like, hardly as before. But it is something that kind of makes people worried. Like, I know when some new people played this game, kind of felt like Gwendolyn's kind of treated extra badly in this game because she's forced to love someone like this, when really it's not. She ends up naturally falling for it. Speaking of absolute, you know, getting fucked over, this woman right here. Also, as you can see, I did gain some levels. I finally went to the Puka Village and used my investment of Valentinian coins we picked up throughout the game, our playthrough as Oswald, to, you know, take care of business here. Alright, let's get some life, get that material, and a key. I don't really feel good about getting this key, given the fact that, you know, it's like, I feel like you go out of your way to earn things, and it doesn't feel as good here, because it's like, whatever, you know? It's like, whatever, you just gave it to me at the start. Alright, so get to the boss. No boundaries, no boundaries. A level that makes, so we have to fall into that rest point. Then we go up. This rest point here has a key door. So it'd just be one key door then. One key door is all we have to worry about. It might need three lamps though. I could very easily see this game pulling some shit and forcing me to have three flames. We'll go up to the door regardless to see. But I'm thinking that's what they want. So I have to give my overall thoughts. I think Oswald's probably, he's a really fun character control. I think I might prefer Mercedes. But really, all the characters are really fun in their own way. But I'm really excited as we're getting ever so closer to finishing the game. And I'm really glad I went on an easier difficulty just to get more stuff done. As a result, obviously I have to edit portions of the videos to make them flow a little bit better. You know, like the beginning, like save prompts and, you know, prep before I start a new video. But I'm going to end up finishing Oswald's story in about 3 hours, which is pretty good. Pretty good. So this is what I need. You need four blue flames. Four? I knew it couldn't be that easy. Or I should have known. Well, then, you know what that means. That means that the last blue flame that we need is all the way in the downward area on the map. I was hoping it'd be a nice express ticket to the end of the game, but, you know. We can't always get what we want. Saving your loved one is not always easy. Not much to say about this boss besides, yo, she's super durable and kind of annoying. But it's fun because she's bird, and I'm a fan of burbs. Probably pick up this toxin, throw it at her, throw that blaze, throw the cyclone, throw this volcano. Okay, that seems to be sufficient. Alright, I think she got my point across. I think she gets my point. I think she understands what my desires are, and they all involve her being fucking dead. Maybe make her burn a little bit here. Oh, she stunned me and summoned a fucking power geyser. Look at this. And now she's trying to fly away. And now I'm dead. I died. I guess I need to stop assuming that I'm just God in this game. Because I just attempted to tank her. And that did not work out. Oh, got her. Not gonna lie, I died again off screen. I had planned to cut it out anyway, but I died. Basically, what did I learn from that? Don't face fuck the bird boss bitch whenever she does her lava geyser attack. That just straight up just melts my health instantly. I say that because I didn't do it that time, and I got off scot-free. What is this crystal here? Good at the battle stage. I was worried I was going to have to fight a boss. Luckily, that was not the case. That's a lot of numbers. In fact, our combo's about to break like 300 at this rate. Oh my god. Yeah. Can I do it? Can I? Oh, I almost got 500. Denied right at the end. I'm so sad about that. That would have been awesome. This definitely is a 4-star stage, though. It's like Oswald deals 500 hits, more than 500 hits, still hasn't cleared out the enemies. In fact, there's still another wave filled with them. Skill that I went out of my way to obtain. Oh wait, is this his ultimate ability? Dan's Slave. Well, unfortunately, I can't use it. It's the one move that I cannot use because my level is too low. I could try and power grind my way up there. In theory, I'd have to gain 8 levels. Man, they ask for a lot just to have him be able to do it. Where the hell would the 4th flame be? Huh. My guess would it had to be up. And then to the right. As expected, an ice cyclone. Oh good, the flame's right here. Well, that makes 4 of them. You know, that was a lot easier than I expected. I feel like I say that a lot with a lot of things, but that seriously was a lot easier than I expected. Huh? Won't let me... Ah, okay. There we go. This is the most insane door requirement ever. 4 keys. 4 keys, man. All right, try not to die on the way down. And boss is to the right. Another rest zone. There's a bell. Now, what's the good stuff I can get? I doubt I will be able to get Dan's Life very easily, so we may not... This may be the one ability that we'll have to wait till the end game to show off, though. We'll see. We'll see what I have to... What's some of the highest experience item, like, foods that I can make. Herb roasted shrimp. Ruwort and a shrimp. That's a lot of money. Am I thinking about doing a grinding session? I'm thinking about it. The grinding session that you would end up not seeing as a result, but... Sell everything we don't need. We don't need that. We will keep all of these. I don't know if yogurt will matter, but I'll get it anyway. Oh, I already have a bunch of root word. Okay. Cool. That's a lot of money. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I need 870. All right, I need to find a way to make 50 more. Okay. Fuck. I need the rose mob because I need something to grow. 10. Do I literally just not have enough here? I'm literally short. Unless I get rid of one of these. What do I get rid of then? Get rid of quick charge. Alright. Do that, buy 1, 2, 3, 4 shrimps and 1 Ruward. I have to hope this gives me enough levels. I don't know if it will, and if it doesn't, I can grind off screen. Alright, let's feed it. These things require a lot of Fozon. A lot. Like, I've used over 100. Okay. The results of my hard work.
Welcome to Mori's Touring. Now then.
Herb roasted shrimp. Actually, hold on. Let's have the yogurt first on the off chance it actually matters for home-cooked meals. I doubt it does, but whatever. I'm not gonna use it anyway. Otherwise. Literally the most expensive and high experience thing I can get. Okay, yeah, we're gonna get it. We're probably gonna make it. Actually, we're not. Our cipher actually isn't gaining the amount that I wanted it to. It actually isn't. It's still staying at 42. Well, that's a fucking bummer.
Is there anything else you want to order?
Now all I'm doing is making myself impossible to die. Actually, given that Oswald at endgame has the hardest final boss of the three, of the five, maybe that's good. Damn it, how the hell am I gonna get stronger? Could it be these? Oh, I just realized I have not messed with abilities on my last two characters. I have not done any of these. Oh my god. I forgot to do these with Mercedes. Like, these straight up really make your attributes all the more better. Like, all the more better. Is that a statement that makes sense? I don't know. Well, my apologies for not making use of this shit. Because this stuff would have made me a lot stronger. Like, obviously, we kind of know who we're taking on here with King Onyx. He's fucked. I mean, I just gave Oswald an ability that means if he kills me, I come back once with 10% HP. You're so unbelievably screwed. Recover POW when defeating enemies. I should have done this earlier because it's a bonus for food. Increase damage dealt up to 30% if my HP is low, which means Avenger will pop and do even more damage even when I die, because then I'll come back with 10 HP, so that'll be doing 30% more. In Berserk mode, my recovery speed for POW is doubled. Nullify status effects. Holy crap. Holy crap. Decrease damage received by half when I am in Berserk. Berserk is also on maximum time because I maxed that out. And warp to any direction of my choice. Alright, through going through this game, I got all but four of these chests open. Completely forgot that these were a thing. Ah, these abilities do increase your PP. It seems like all of them do, actually. And if all of them do, then we know what to do. Invest in a bunch of low-level ones that don't require nearly as much Fozon use from me. We have a bunch of low-level skills here, I assume. Because I always want to show off the cool super techniques in the game before we finish. Like, that is something that I really like doing in the in these LPs. Ah, good. Got this one. Look at all this on-screen, like, powering up I'm showing. I have no idea if this was enough. If not, we can grind out some Fozons. We have 3 short. Okay, I'm gonna have to grind that out. Alright, everybody, we're back, finally. We're gonna go take on the boss, since we finally, as you can see, have enough PP to launch the ultimate move. And as a result, we are more than ready to take him on. We're within 3 levels. Let's go get Gwendolyn back.
Gwendolyn. You're still asleep. I made it in time.
You brutal man. Do not take another step towards my queen, you hooligan.
Your queen, eh?
When she awakens, she will be mine due to a spell. She shall find a new life here and join my court.
I won't let that happen.
She shall become the bride of Onyx, the ruler of these fiery lands. Having her as a wife will do wonders for my reputation. Of course, she will enjoy it as well.
You and Odin, those with power are truly selfish beings. If all you want is a tool to help you gain power, look elsewhere. Return Gwendolyn to me.
What? Are you a knight in shining armor here to rescue her? Bah! Look at yourself. I can smell the stench of death that follows you like a shadow. It sickens me. Tis the scent of that domineering wench in the netherworld. I, the ruler of the Fire Kingdom, find it repugnant. My fury awakens from the pit of my stomach. Let me show you my true figure, as described in the prophecies.
It's been a while, but we finally have a brand new boss. We end Oswald's story with fighting Onyx. He's big. He's strong. We're well prepared for him. We're gonna save our ultimate technique for the very end and hope that it can kill him for style points. Basically, what does he do? He charges you. He burns things. That's about it. He's just a big bruiser. He could prove to be difficult, though, so let's unload our good techniques. Also, he's gonna kind of melt a little bit more than other bosses, because I've gained quite a few levels because I had to get myself up to snuff. Then, because I accidentally thought that your in-game levels are what increased PP, when it turns out it took me 4 stories to realize, oh yeah, PP is increased through through leveling up your skills. I do not remember this move. Regardless, it is annoying. Oh, he also glows red hot like that and then charges you. Do a quick dodge. Oh god! I was not actually expecting to pop up there like that. Whatever, I'll regain some health. Oh, he also has Rocket Punch. Why? Cause fucking I don't know. Am I dead? Actually, I think I just got revived through the effects of my own stuff. Hold on. Hold on. We are in a bad way right now. That's a full heal. But would I wanna waste it here? I do have a boss fight to do later once we're on the final chapter of the game. I have cacaos. I can eat these damn things. Hold on. Just eat this shit. The painkiller is gonna wear off, so I'm gonna be taking full damage again. But whatever, it's just something we're gonna have to deal with. Keep beating the tar at him. Unfortunately, he does an insane amount of damage, so we still have to be very careful. Luckily, our own powerful moves can knock him out of his powered-up state, looks like. Okay. How about a cyclone? You probably don't like ice. Nice. All right, last gauge. All right, let's get him close to death and then unleash our ultimate move. God, that stomp is so horrifying. Luckily, I've kind of avoided a lot of his high damaging stuff by now. Oh, he's just fucking doing auto on me. Jesus. Alright, that's more than enough. Let's unleash Deinsleif. Unlock the power of darkness, unleashing a mad frenzy. Got him. I guess we overkilled him.
I shall regret it, but if I must hand her to you, I would rather.
Lay one finger on her, and I will reduce you to ashes before you can scream.
I don't believe this. You do not have the authority to tear us apart. Will you take her by force, like a vicious thief? What of my own feelings? My soul burns with a beast called love. I cannot attempt to leash it. How can I live with these feelings? And to lose her to you in one terrible moment.
Your words are my thoughts exactly.
Go ahead, kiss her. Wake her up. But she will not love you. A spell causes her slumber. The demon Lord Odin came and told me this. But there is no spell on her that can control her heart.
Is this why you did not wake her? Because you knew that she would not love you.
Yes. When she wakes, she'll flee. And if that is the case, I would rather keep her here, asleep and under my control. What?
I see. Her heart. It cannot be manipulated. Good. Inferno King, I apologize for my rudeness. I wish to ease some of your pain. Should King Onyx desire it, I shall wield my sword for you just once. That is all I can do.
Do not think you can restore my honor with this pledge.
Just remember one thing. While I still live, I will not let you near her. What will you think when you see me as you awaken? Will you hate me? Will you run away forever? Such musings are pointless. I can't go back to the man I used to be. No matter how you react, and even if it only brings me pain, I want to see my reflection in your eyes. I want to hear those soft lips speak my name. And if, for a moment, a smile lights your face, I will be able to live. No one controls me now. From now on, I act on my own for you.